Looking for a way to visualize your Airtable records on a timeline? The Gantt block might be your perfect solution. The Gantt block visualizes records over time by displaying each record as a horizontal bar within the block. The length and position of each bar denote the start date, end date, and duration of each activity, and the bars are stacked into rows so that you can easily see which activities overlap and for how long. In many cases, a project plan will require that activities be performed in a certain order. For example, if you were planning a conference, you would have to finalize the keynote speakers before distributing the press release. A Gantt chart will let you visualize how different activities depend on each other with arrows, called dependencies, connecting the different bars. Airtable's Gantt chart is available as part of Airtable Blocks, which is a pro plan feature. Blocks let you extend the functionality of your bases by visualizing and summarizing your records in dynamic and colorful ways. If you're not already on our pro plan, sign up for our free trial to try out all of our blocks, including Gantt. Setting up your Gantt block is easy. First, make sure that you already have a table containing the tasks, projects, or other time-bound activities that you want to plot on your Gantt chart. At minimum, this table must include two date fields, one that holds a record start date and another that holds its end date. You'll also need a view with all of the records you want displayed in the Gantt block. Now, let's unfurl the Blocks panel and add a new Gantt block. Using the Settings panel, we can customize our Gantt chart. The block will have already pre-selected the table and view that you currently have open, so change these options as necessary by selecting the table and view you actually want to pull from. Next, you'll need to pick a Start Date field and an End Date field. These fields will be used to define the duration for each record and plot your records on the chart. Now, click Done. You now have an interactive timeline of all of your activities. Notice that the primary fields of the records are listed in a collapsible column on the far left, and their start and end dates are depicted as bars on a horizontal graph. This way, you can see the overall timeline of your activities at a glance. You can change the timeline to show a variety of different durations, from an entire year to a single week. The arrows let you move backwards or forwards on the timeline. There's also a handy Today button, so you can shift the Gantt chart to show the current date. And if you want to adjust the start or end date of any record, simply click and drag the bar to your liking. Now that we've covered the basics, let's explore a few ways to customize your Gantt chart even further. Let's say that your tasks can be separated into different categories, like marketing or talent procurement. If you'd like to view your tasks by their category, choose to group by that field in the Blocks Settings panel. You can also customize the color of the records in your Gantt chart. You have a few options here. First, you can assign a single color of your choosing to the entire chart. You can also color code your graph by a classification in a select field. Finally, if you've already set up conditional record coloring in the view you're using to define your Gantt chart, selecting By View will apply those colors to your Gantt chart. In some cases, a project plan or schedule will require that activities be performed in a certain order. For example, you need to secure keynote speakers before sending out a press release. You can visualize these dependent relationships between different tasks with arrows, called dependencies, connecting the different bars. The arrow reflects the direction of the dependency. The base of the arrow comes out of the record that needs to be completed first, which is called the predecessor, and points towards the record that can only be started after the predecessor's completion, which is called the successor. To show dependencies on your Gantt chart, you need a field listing either a record's predecessors or successors. If you don't already have a field containing this information, create a new linked record field. I'll name mine Blocked By and use it for predecessors. But instead of linking to another table, I'll link to the tasks table itself so I can reference other tasks on the same list. Now, I'll navigate to the Gantt chart settings panel and choose my newly created field from the dependency drop-down menu. I'll also make sure to choose predecessors instead of successors. Click Done, and now you're ready to start drawing some dependencies. Start off by hovering your mouse over any bar on the chart. This will reveal a white circle on the bar's perimeter. Click here and drag your cursor over to any other record on the chart to establish a dependency. And as you draw dependency arrows, the linked record field you created will automatically populate with that same information. If you already have a field with predecessors or successors, say because you imported an existing spreadsheet into Airtable, customize its field type to convert it to a self-linking linked record field. All of its existing information will then automatically be transformed into linked records. Now, select your new linked record field in the block settings panel, and your dependencies will instantly appear on your Gantt chart. You'll notice that some dependencies may be outlined in gold. This golden line is called the critical path, which is the longest path that ends in the item with the last end date. Essentially, if anything on this path is altered, it'll affect the overall end date for the entire project. The critical path is here to help you make informed decisions when moving around dates on your Gantt chart. If a dependency appears with a red line, it means that the dependency is invalid. It could be that a dependent record is scheduled to start prior to one of its preceding tasks, or that the records are in a dependency loop. In these cases, simply click on the warning icon to address the inconsistencies. If you'd like to remove a dependency, you can click on a record in the sidebar to view any predecessors or successors. Simply click on the X icon to remove either one. When dealing with dependencies, keep in mind that adjusting the start and end dates of a record can affect other records that have been linked to it. For instance, if you change the end date of a predecessor to end later than the start date of any of its successors, the start dates of those successors will automatically shift back to accommodate this change. The same thing happens if the start date of a record occurs before its predecessor's end date. This way, regardless of how you move things around, Airtable will adjust the dates of all dependencies to preserve the order of operations that you have established. If you'd like to shift the dates of a task without creating this ripple effect, simply hold the Command key while you click and drag. And you can easily undo and redo changes made through the chart by clicking the curved arrow icons in the upper right corner of the block. You can also add records from within the block itself by clicking the plus icon in the bottom right corner of the screen. Now that you've learned the essentials, go ahead and give it a try on your own. Add a Gantt chart to one of your block's dashboards and see how it can enrich your workflow. If you have any questions, check out our support article for more information about the Gantt block. If you'd like to learn even more, feel free to visit our community forum or just drop us a line directly. We can't wait to see what you create.